So let's look at how we can connect a search account to some other type of storage account and use an automatic indexer to populate our search service. So here you see I have in my Azure portal a search service and a document DB account. For the purposes of this document DB account, I'm just going to create a simple database. I'm going to call this database users. Hit OK. Within the users database, I can have different collections. Again, just going to keep things really simple. I'm just going to add a collection. And this collection, I'm going to call it employees. And I'm not going to change any of the default values. I'm just going to leave it all as it is. So now I have a users database and employees collection. I can go into here. For my purposes, I'm going to use the Document Explorer. The Document Explorer is just a quick way for me to add documents in here without having to write a script or anything like that. For my documents, I actually have a folder with 100 JSON files with just pretend test data. For example, each of the JSON files just have an individual user, unique ID, first name, last name, email, country, and a pseudo IP address. So I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna go to that folder and I'm gonna select all those users. Again, this is just for testing. In reality, you use an automation script to upload all of these documents or even just a REST API call. But here you can see this is a quick way for me to test things out and get comfortable with Document DB and get used to how things work here. Okay, so I should have quite a few documents in here. And it looks like the very first person that's uploaded was Michael Miller, and then the second person was Maria Gonzalez. If I go back to the home page, I can go to my search service and I can actually create what's called an indexer. The way I do that is I click this import data button and I specify data source. Now I want to specify Document DB as my data source, so I click that. I'm just going to call this Doc DB employees, and a connection string. Well, I don't know what that is. I need to go back to my DocDB instance. So I'm going to click the active button and switch right back to my DocDB instance. I'm going to go in here at the DocDB account level. I'll be able to click this key button and it should give me access to my keys. I have a primary connection string right here, so I can copy that and then switch again right back over to my search service. So I'm going to paste in that connection string. The only other thing they require and right is to specify a database. So my database is called users, so that's easy enough. And a collection is called employees. If I hit OK, it's actually going to get information from there unless I specify something wrong. It looks like I just typed something in wrong. That's no problem. Just do it one more time. Import data, data source, document DB, connection string, database equals users, dot DB, employees, and a collection is going to be called employees. Hit OK. And now it's able to scan that and return back the different fields. Now, I could just take it as it is, but one thing I'll notice is that this TS field is not a valid field name as far as our search is concerned. If I try to modify this, it's going to complain back to, hey, a TS a search field can't start with an underscore or anything like that. So I'll just go ahead and just remove that. Not going to really use that field. For the other fields, I'm going to name this index. So I'm going to call this employees. I can specify a key field. For me, ID is perfectly fine. I want to be able to retrieve things by ID. I want to be able to search on first name, last name, email, country, or IP address. I would love to be able to facet on country and sort on country, maybe sort on first and last name. Be able to filter on pretty much all of these values. And definitely when I do a search, I want to retrieve all of them back. And probably, I think it'd be okay if I could search on ID. So to me, that seems pretty good. Retrievable is just it coming back when you do a search query. Filterable means you can filter on that property. Not everything makes sense to filter on. Sortable means you can sort on that property. Sorting on things like first name, last name may make sense. Sorting all IP addresses, email, really depends on your application scenario. Facetable basically means you can break it down into categories. So if you're used to a search engine, like a popular web store, you'll see that on the left-hand side, it shows different categories that you can drill down. Those are called facets. So for me, I like to be able to create facets out of the country so that if I get search results back, I can sort them by country or drill down into specific countries if I wanted to. So I'm going to hit OK. This should be everything I need for my index, and I just give this indexer a name. I'm just going to call it .db employees, and I hit OK. I create my indexer, and that's pretty much it. What's going to happen now is once it's done and created the index, I'll be able to click down here, indexers, and see .db employees ran, and it found 100 documents, and 100 documents succeeded. So wonderful. So if I go to this employees index, I'll see that I have the fields that I specified earlier. I can now start using it. So in order to use a search service, what we really need is the account key. So I'm going to copy either my primary or secondary admin key if I wanted to give admin access, or I can actually create a query key, which is just read-only access. Since this is just a search query, I'm going to use a query key because that just makes more sense to me. Now, if I wanted to actually do a search against this service, what I have to do is I have to open up some type of HTTP tool. I'm going to use Postman, but you can use hurl.it, you can use Fiddler. And I'm just going to make a request to HTTP sydneysearch.search.windows.net. Now, under here, I can specify index. My index is going to be called employees. And then from there, I can go and do a search. Now, you see I had another index before called users, but I don't have that one right now. So for employees, what I do is I call the docs endpoint and specify query parameters. Just to begin, I'm gonna just do search. So you see I have a parameter search, and I'm gonna use a wildcard character for search. I do have to authorize. There's two ways you have to do this. You have to specify API key. And then you also have to specify what is called an API version. If you don't know what the API version is, and I can never remember it, if you go to MSDN, it will always tell you what the latest API version is. So if you go down here, this is an example of different things you can do in a search query. Down, they have an API version. They say the current version is 2015, February 28th. So I'm going to put that in as my API version. Hit send, and I get a search result back. So I see near the top, Michael Miller and Maria Gonzalez. And this is actually an index. So if I go to DocDB and update it, so let me go actually manipulate these documents. So I go to my users database, go to employees collection, and I can use the document explorer. Again, you know, I'm just using this explorer to keep this very visual so it's easy for you to follow along with what I'm doing. And instead of Michael Miller, I'm gonna use the name Steven. Hit save, and there we go. Successfully saved the document. Now I can switch back to the search account and go down to the indexers. And I can see that the DocDB employees indexer ran 3 minutes ago. I can keep refreshing until I see a time it ran that I'm happy with. Right now, it's still 3 minutes ago. So it takes a little while for the indexer to run, but once the indexer runs, it will actually update with the new information. When I say it takes a while, I mean seconds. I'm not talking about minutes or hours. And this is the automatic indexer. There's nothing stopping you from writing your own indexer or writing your own algorithm on when to check, listening to programmatic features, listening to updates, deciding, you know, what's appropriate to check and what's appropriate to go get the latest record. I'm going to close this and reopen to see if it's not caching the value. And what I'm going to do real quick is I'm going to go over here to search engine. And that search we did earlier, we can actually go and do some more stuff. So we can say facet is true. Or we can facet on the country. If I hit send, now it'll actually tell me that 16 of the people in the search results. And I'm just searching for wildcard, so this is everybody in the database or the collection, excuse me, 16 from China, 12 are from Indonesia, 6 from Russia, and 6 are from Portugal. I can go in here, back to MSDN, and look at other things I can do. Like for instance, I could set count to true, which is from OData. If I set count to true, it'll actually tell me the total number of results, even though it's only returning a subset. So it's gonna tell me that the total number of results is 100, but the subset it's returning is only the top X number. And I can even specify that top. So I can say top 5. So still the count is 100 and the facets is based upon the total set, but I'm only getting a page of results. So this is really good if you have a web application, you want to minimize the amount of extra data you're pulling down. You can even do your own query. So I did that search. Let me actually search on the term Miller. Hit send and return Michael Miller. So we'll go back in here to the indexers. Let's close out and reopen it. I can either wait for an indexer to run or I can run it manually. So I'm gonna run the indexer manually because I guess I don't have any sense of patience, right? Now go down here and it shows that that result that we had from Michael Miller, he's from Japan. So my facets say Japan. But if I search one more time, it's now Stephen Miller. And again, same facets from Japan. I can search on additional data. So maybe if I know there's a common name I want, I can search on that. I can search on IP address. I can search on last name. A lot of flexibility on what I can do here in the search engine. And again, I can use the indexers manually where they index whenever I click the button, or I can set up automatic indexing where it indexes on its own, or I can write my own logic for indexing and skip the Azure Search indexers altogether.